The easiest way to evoke in the Blender, I can easily manipulate these settings, because volume overlapped all the details of the sky. So we will have deep space with denoise, because I can add fog in compositing. But let's start with something simpler to understand the difference in each method of creating fog in Blender. The first way to add fog in Blender is by using volume scatter. I need to cover my scene with some object like a cube, like this one. Adjust the scale to cover the whole object in this scene, and let's make sure it doesn't distract us, just make it the visibility of this cube is bounds. Now I can add a new material, and I need volume scatter instead of principal VSDF material. This is a simpler volume material with the settings of color and density. Everything that I need to adjust the settings to get a nice result. If I make a cube invisible, the scene will look like this. Alright, connect the volume scatter to the volume socket and we already have a fog, as we can see. I would prefer to make the density around 0.1 to make the details in the scene more visible. Also, we can change a color if it's necessary, depending on your goals and whatever. The second way is the same, but I'm going to use principal volume material. This one has more settings and I have more control of the volume in the scene. In addition to the same settings that already in the volume scatter, there is at least one interesting feature, emission strings, which allow us to add emission to the volume, adding even more density to our fog. Ready to elevate your Blender skills to new heights? Join me in unlocking the secret of artistic mystery with my exclusive Blender Masterclass. In this immersive experience, I'll guide you through creating this atmospheric Blender scene from the initial concept to achieving stunning results. Discover the art of creating atmospheric life, master using megascans for realistic environment, and dive into the world of cinematic animation in Blender. Follow the links to accept more information and take the first step towards unleashing your creative potential. Don't miss out! Let's turn your artistic vision into reality. Volume allows us to create atmospheric effect and atmospheric light, create sun rays and make epic artwork in a Blender, but it has some disadvantage. The first one is render time. Render with volume will be going much longer and it also requires more power of your PC because you have to increase samples to get clear result. Besides, the use of volume is not always appropriate. For example, when I have a big enough Blender scene and I need to add atmosphere, I could also add a huge cube and the volume material. But it doesn't make sense when we can do all this using a more practical way. This scene is already quite heavy. There are a lot of plants, grass and a lot of displacement. So adding volume fog here doesn't make sense because I can add fog in compositing. This is the easiest way to add some fog in the Blender by using depth space, which help us to work with the Z depth and add fog effect over the render in compositing. Depth space contains all information about the depth of the scene. But let me show you step by step how to use this way to add an atmospheric fog to your Blender artwork. The first step, go to the view layer and here we can find ZPath and denoise data. These two paths contain all the necessary information that we need to work with. But in the denoise data we will have depth space with denoise due to the cycles making denoise only for the beauty render. I saved all paths in EXR multilayer format. Here is the depth information that I need to add a fog. If I connect depths to the viewer, we may see something here, but it mostly white image and doesn't look I have shown before. To work with the depths in a Blender, we need to extract information from this path by using a map range node. This node allows us to select some range of the whole depth information and use this information. I want to add atmosphere from the middle to the background in this art, somewhere here. Now I am adding mix color node to the main render and if I connect map range to the factor, this second color impacts my render using information from the depth space that I selected. Just need to check clamp to clamp selected range. I can change the color to bluish and change the blending mode to screen. But as we can see, I made a render with transparent background, and now I can add to my artwork a simple image of the sky. I already have this setup with sky. Here is my image. Next, I added a scale node to resize this image to my render size, transform to move this image, and the hue saturation node to reduce saturation a little bit. I need to connect this image to my render. To do this, I'm going to use alpha over node. Connect this node to my render, just to the second input and the image to the first. And now I have a sky in the render. But the problem is this mix node doesn't affect the sky. This is because we don't have any information in the depth space. Here is the black hole, as we can see. It means that we need to cover this black hole with a white color related to the white color of the depth space. To do this, I add the alpha over node between map range and mix color, but connect the map range to the second input. The first one is left white, and connect alpha to the factor. Now my depth space looks like this. This white color in the alpha over node now is a one pass, and everything that happened here will be impacted to the whole image. If you made a render without transparent background, you will have this information in the depth space, so you do not need to do this in your case. Alright, these three nodes are my fog setup. I can easily manipulate these settings, like changing the color and selecting different ranges. Finally, for fog setup, I would add a glare node. It brings some glow effect to the art. I also made a render from this scene with volume fog, as I have shown in the beginning of this video, to see the difference between each method of creating fog in a Blender. So, this one is render with volume, and this one which we done in compositing. Except there is a visual difference where we added the sky in the compositing. It's more expressive here, because here the volume overlapped all the details of the sky. I can say about render time, and here is what we have. I made both render in 4K resolution with 256 samples, and the render time for the render with volume was 13 minutes and 27 seconds. But for this one, render time was 6 minutes and 19 seconds. 2 times faster, and also we have more flexibility using compositing and adding fog as a post effect using a depth space in a Blender. Of course, each method has advantages, and you need to analyze your scene which way will be more convenient for you. Creating gut rays is easier with volume scatter, but if you need to add atmosphere, you can use ZPS in Blender and compositing. Depending on the level of your skills, you can combine all these ways. Add something in 3D scene and finish something in compositing. Blender allows you to do all this in one program, so learn different ways to create the same things to be more flexible and not waste time where you can do something faster. Hit the like button if you found some useful information. Don't forget to subscribe. Also to my Instagram and Patreon, where you may find Blender scene from this video to get some compositing node setup and volume settings as in this tutorial. And I hope to see you in the next one.